In your mind, the image of a man who always has a twinkle in his eyes, a childlike smile, a serene aura, and a calm demeanor. An inspiring role model, Dr. Pritam Singh has spent his entire life tirelessly doing what he does best, awakening students, academia, corporate heads, and policymakers to raise their excellence to the next level. As the chairman and member of several policymaking committees and bodies of Government of India, he has stamped his perspective on policy issues that surround both management education and corporate management in India. As a consultant, Dr. Pritam Singh has done work with more than 200 CEOs in India and abroad, and conducted more than 100 retreats for the top management of both private and public sector organizations, as well as for multinational corporations. Indeed, he's the guru, the trainer, the coach, and the counselor of the board and the top management level of the Indian corporate world, as we have seen today. In a fitting tribute to this change maestro, it was Dr. Pritam Singh who was entrusted with the distinction of organizing and directing the first retreat of the central ministers as part of the late Shri Rajiv Gandhi's initiative to develop ministers as a transformation leaders and change masters. It has been said here also before. As an academic administrator, Dr. Pritam Singh has an unparalleled record. He is a globally sought after speaker and has addressed various Indian and global audiences. Dr. Singh has been the member and the chairman of some of the most important government committees. His services were acknowledged by the country where the President of India conferred on him the prestigious Padma Shri Award. It was for the first time that any professor and a serving director in India received this coveted award in the field of management education. In December 2006, Mobis, the leading management school in Moscow, also honored him as the global thought leader for 2006-07. He has also been the recipient of several prestigious awards, which is more than my height. So I will not go into that entire detail. So ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the man himself, Dr. Pritam Singh.
Papaji, he will be going to heaven or he is going to heaven. I was a very small child and my dad said, I have been requesting you, why don't you go to the body of God or some sun god and spend time there and come back and you tell me whether he will be going to heaven or he will be going to heaven. So I went as a curious child and I sat there. In four things were very good. I saw Chaturvedi sahab and saw him. बहुत अच्छा हुआ मर गया, सारे ने बहुत लोगों को परेशान किया। तो फादर ने मुझसे कहा कि तुमने क्या सोचा, तुमने कहा बाबू जी शायद जो है मिल जाएगा लोगों को गाली देने की थोड़ी वो जो थे बेटे एक एक वन वन थिंग आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू व्हाट लेगेसी यू आर गोइंग टू लीव इन योर लाइफ यू मस्ट ऑलवेज Wherever you were, when you leave that place, what people will talk about you, please think about it. I think that I have experienced three times the great excitement in my life. The one was, I got a letter from my dad, whom I adore. He was a highly educated man, only primary school pass, highly educated. And he wrote to me only one letter when I was working in Westinghouse in America. Jungle mein mor na cha kisi ne dekha. And then he said ki budhimano ke liye sara kaafi hai. That was 7th of January. After 7 years of my stay in America, he came back here on 22nd January, 1973. When I landed Indian Airlines, Air India, Indian Airlines and Railways, Chakka Jam, and I went from Delhi to Banaras, 48 hours standing. That was the greatest moment in my life that this country was. The second thing that happened, and that was extremely exciting, that when Rajiv Gandhiji came on 30th of May to administer Punjab, Hyderabad. So I raised a question, as usual, Harbans was talking. But Sabi, ministers for trade, bureaucrats for trade, can be school for them. And in that, Aski was chosen by him. And then he said, what do you mean by that? He said, if a minister for trade, can be school for them. Problem to why? Bureaucrats ke saath koi problem nahi hai. He looked for Dhani Sinha, who was my principal. He said, Dhani, can you take up this job? And Dhani baad mein humse bole ki hamare ka khwa khe sakte hai. Minister ko contact kar le jaye. Then I said, he said ki Pritam will do this. That was the most exciting moment in my life. Third one, Atul was about it, that when I was requested by the PM office to go to MDI, to go to IIM, I asked Jorilal that whether I should go from a city to a village, because there he was city and Atul was village for me. Atul ji, I hope that you will not mind about that. And he told me only one thing. Dr. Singh, how many lucky persons are there where they are asked by the Prime Minister to go to some place? I never met him, he was not knowing about him. When Padma Award business came, he told R.P. Singh sitting there, R.P. Singh was his, the one who went to World Bank, he said, Suna Sardar wahan par baitha hua bahut acha kaam kar raha hai. Usko award dene mein kya harch hoga? Tu kya sochte ho? Kya kya score Sardar sir? Oh, Pritam Singh, मैं सरदार नहीं हूँ। That was another exciting moment, you know, that when I got that one. It was from where it came, I did. The third most exciting thing was when Moscow State University honored me with Global Thought Leaders Award. About 5,000 people were in that function. That was the biggest function, and I think that they asked me to speak something, and I spoke, and after that the media heard out me, and they asked me that, how do you feel? And my response was, I am feeling miserable. Today I am really feeling miserable. So they all were surprised that, why, how come actually you are feeling miserable? You should feel very excited that out of 19 thought leaders, 9 are Nobel laureates, and you are also one of them. Now, how, why do you feel miserable? Then I said, now I have to prove that I deserve this honor. I am feeling extremely miserable, Bhaskar. Arunta Sahab, Chaturvedi Sahab, Atul ji, my friend, actually, Bakun, that now whatever you have spoken, is it truth or non-truth? Atul ji ki ek sabse badi khasiyat ye hai. He's very first, forthright and very frank. So while selecting the independent directors, he found me a very forthright and very frank person. And he told me only one thing, Pritam, hum aur aap is board mein baithe hain, ek kuch achhe independent directors ko hum log le chahiye. And I remember very well, hum log baar baar naam ko ministry ko bhejna shuru kar diye ki nahi isko hum log lenge. To koi ek security sahab aaye to bole sahab, acha ek to le lijiye. Mantri ka bahut kaafi iske bare mein, isko to karai dijiye aap. Jab aap kitni hamare taraf dekhe to unka sab ek ko accommodate kar lene mein koi harm nahi. So it was a very wonderful kind of thing to work with him. And today while I was sitting with him, he said, at this juncture, public enterprises, they need much better, much bigger, and much greater interventions. They have been the great institutions. I think this country, whatever this country has been today, I think public enterprises have played a very, very significant role, I must say. I think that I am not a Mr. Fahd, but I would like to say that they have played a very significant role. The question is that, Atulji, the question of race, how to bring the semblance of the great administration employees. And that's where I find that your role and the role of some of the management schools and academic institutions is very, very important. I think that, so friends, I think that it's a, I don't know whether it's a moment of truth or it's chand lamhe jisko hum zindagi bhar yaad karte rahenge. But one thing more which I would like to say, I have experienced many failures in my life. I did become the director of IIM Calcutta. And I was just picked up, I was ratified. And I did become the director of IIM Bangalore. But I had to go only as a dean. And someone asked me a question to me, what do you feel about this? When my wife asked me, said, what do you feel about it? And I told my wife, she's not highly educated, she's only got high school pass. So I said, ki jitna fail hote jaoge, utne success ke nazdeek pahunchte jaoge. I think that in all my journey, in all my life, I would like to make only one point. I am an extremely lucky person, I work Atul ji ho, ya Bhaskar ji ho, या रूटा साहब हो या दुबे जी हो या कोई भी व्यक्ति हो, हमने किसी चीज के बारे में पूछा अपनी वाइफ से बोल रहा था, बोले कि भाई यही बात तुम भी सीख लो, हमको नो नहीं बोलना. आई थिंक दैट आई एम वेरी ग्रेटफुल, आई एम रियली ग्रेटफुल Harbans ji ko main khas karke bolta hu, leader of the leaders. And I was talking with Atul ji that he is a very, very great leader. Very few persons you can find of this caliber, passion and intoxication. I would like to say ki hamare bade purane hain. Now I think that national HRD is also moving toward the next orbit. It needs help. And I will be requesting you all friends to help Kamal, because he has come with a very dream, with very different kind of vision to work for the country and to work for the government and to work for the global institutions also. Amit is a very young, budding entrepreneur. I think that I met him first time, so he was my student, but I have been teaching in MDI. And he said, I want to start something. I said, you must start. You really must start. So he said, first MBA universe. He said, ki, I need some money. First MBA universe ke kaam ke liye. Humne kaha ki Dubey ji yahan pe baithe hain, Dubey ji se bol dunga. Dubey ji ne, aapko yaad hoga, 5 lakhs rupees jo hai immediately kaha ke mere. I think that if there is a noble cause, resources are always given by the Lord. But only thing that no good cause ke liye. Many times we fail, many times we succeed, and that's why we always say that success and failure is a part of life. But failure should not determine your endeavor for success. And that's why Lord Krishna made a very powerful statement that yogastha kur karmani mohatyakta dhananjaya. Tumhe yogastha mode mein kaam karte jao. Reward milega ya nahi milega, iske chinta tum karo. Friends, I think that it has been a journey. And I come from very, very lower middle class family. Perhaps I belong to Mirzapur district. And I find that though all education was in Banaras, and you can imagine Mirzapur district is a very, very backward district. In 20 kilometers, I was the first person who had the post graduation. So in that kind of thing, touched, God has been very nice. And I must also say that I remember very well when I was going to for Fulbright, so I was not in a position to speak good English. So he asked me a question, that what kind of English do you speak? And I could understand that he's talking whether I speak Oxfordian English or, you know, that Cambridge English and something like that. So I told him that I speak Bhojpuri English. And they all laughed, you know, And somebody told me later on, your frankness helps us to select a good language. I think that we should be very frank and we should be very honest about that. And Bakuni Hapa Bhatte Huye, we had a mammoth fight with a very powerful minister. Very, very powerful minister. He knows about that. I think that we were going to be sacked. About 2-3 persons were going to be sacked. So I told Bakul, to apna kaam karna Delhi mein apna kaam karta. And we confronted. I think that's where people respect you. I would like to say that you should never give up in the popularity race. You should be frank and forthright. Whatever you want to say, you say. It may be accepted, may not be accepted. And Harvard knows about it. And I think that Bariand also knows about it. Only yesterday we had a meeting. So I think that I confronted with the persons. Atul ji ka to ek sawal hai hamesha. Inke paas jaate samay 10 baar soch karke jao. Jaoge to koi na koi kaam zarur mil jayega. Kabhi jaoge. Ye maine barabar dekha hai. Sir, you have given a very bigger agenda. Bigger agenda man many person pass kar diye sitting here. I think that. Dubeji is also here sitting there. I think that Bakul is also here. Many persons are sitting here. That whatever agenda you want to build. And luckily, you know that Dr. Malyan is here. He would be much more involved with Mr. SRD network. Whatever agenda you are going to be, we will work on that. And they should be the people. Friends, it's a very emotional kind of things. I always consider that I am a very powerful speaker. But today I could realize that maybe that silence is a much bigger way to say whatever you want to say rather than speaking. Thank you very much, all of you. And we decided to participate. The function organized by Harbans ji, Kamal ji, by Amit ji. I think that I will cherish this memory, always I will cherish this memory. And I think that last time the students gave me a farewell, and I think that, and that they put on the YouTube. And I think that when I went to, so my third son, he has got two children, like two grandchildren, and they are only about 11 years, 13 years. So they must have seen that YouTube at least about 10 times. So Vivek told me, you have created a tremendous amount of problem for me. So I said, what problem? He said, my children say, Dadaji aisa banna hai aapko.
This evening is really a remarkable evening. I think there is so much to take from this evening for all of us. how do you build a legacy, and how do you build a legacy amongst peers? Truly great individuals who remember your contribution for a decade, 2 decades, 3 decades, and 4 decades. That's what, as a young, relatively young person in the room, that's what I'm going to be taking back. I will not take more than 120 seconds. I will just say 2 things and then possibly conclude the evening. One is that we don't, in India, celebrate our heroes. I think that's one of the saddest part of we as a nation. We are the nation which is obsessed with people who's there occupying the chair, but then forgetting about it. This is possibly, one lacuna in our system where we are not celebrating our heroes. We are not really living the rich legacy of their contribution, how they created institutions which are truly world-class institutions. You look at West, you look at intellectual superstars like Michael Porter, or you look at Dean Jacob of Kellogg, the whole world knows about them. But why does the world not know about Dr. Pritam Singh? And the moment he stepped down from being the DG of IMI, this is the first thing that we discussed, 3 of us, that we are going to be celebrating the fact that he's made great contributions. And this celebration is not a celebration that will end with this evening. This celebration will go on, and we have great heroes and we have great icons like Dr. Bakundulakya in this room and several others in the room, and we need to build a culture of celebrating our heroes. That's my point number one. Point The other is, very briefly, we talked about Dr. Pritam Singh ji as a man with a Midas touch. And I've experienced this in the last 7 or 8 years that I've been part of MBAUniverse.com. We built this organization. We work with about 200 business schools in the country. And I can say with humility that our understanding of management education, which is Dr. Sarv's Karam Bhumi, is second to none. I personally work with about 100-150 deans, directors, chairmen, vice chancellors, blah, blah, blah. What makes Dr. Pritam Singh unique is that there are 3 types of individuals: thinkers, and there are many, doers, which are a lot less, and givers. When you've got a combination of thinkers, doers, and givers, that's the unique combination of Dr. Pritam Singh. He is not just a thinker, he does things. And that's the man of the Midas touch. But he doesn't stop there. He's actually a giver. Moment you walk into his room, and this has happened a million times, Amit, tumhari kya zarurat hai? What is it that I can do for you? Forget about what I need. What is it that you need? And that's the key concern. And that's what 90% of the time in the meeting is going to be spent. And then people say, for instance, business school rankings. I have been in the ranking business for now 6 years and possibly built the most credible ranking in the country. I can vouch, never for once has he said, Amit, our ranking should be like this or that. All he said is, Amit, see, these are the 10 things that we've done in the last 12 months. And you can see, you can check, you can verify, and that's all I have to say. Yes, rest, it is for you to assess, to monitor. Never does he influence a process. He's a great communicator, a great human being, and I'm going to be requesting all of you to now stand up and please give a standing ovation to Dr. Pritam Singh. A huge round of applause, a huge standing ovation, celebrating our heroes. That's what we want. That's the culture we need to build for India of 2050. And with this, I think we'll conclude. May you please take your seats. We'll conclude the evening. And I will just simply say that there are several people in the room that we missed out for paucity of time. Dr. Verma, Dr. J.K. Das, Rajneesh Ji, Ashok Ji, Sanjay Ji, professor from MDI, Dr. Ashok Kapoor, Suresh Jain, several of you who we could not accommodate, who we could not request for you to speak. Our apologies for that. hope you'll forgive us. And now, let us please have a great dinner. Let's enjoy this evening.
Thank you, sir. That brings us to the close of this program. Please join us for dinner. Thank you all and have a great weekend.